The presbyter name of Jesus, my God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I give you the glory, I give you honor in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, we worship you. We adore you. We acknowledge your name. You are everything to us. As we call upon your presence, we call upon you. Oh God, my Father, we love you. We worship you. We honor you. We acknowledge your name. We thank you, Jesus. You are wonderful. Welcome. Welcome, Holy Spirit. Welcome, Jesus. Welcome to our hearts. Welcome to our presence. Oh God, we love you. We thank you, Jesus. My God and my Father, we give all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God is good. Yes. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We give glory and honor. We magnify your name. You are worthy. You are wonderful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you, newcomers. Thank you, first timers. Thank you for joining. God bless you. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I'm going to talk to you. The subject call. The subject call, what of deliverance and protection from affliction. Water of deliverance and protection from affliction. There's some things that we people, they have no idea, we ignore, and it is really working, it is saving, it is protecting. Water, before the heart was created, before anything, there was water, which means water is very, very, very important to the kingdom of God. And the same time into the kingdom, to the kingdom of the devil. Before anything, the Bible says it was only water. Nothing, nothing was there, but water was there. Which means water is so powerful, and that's why the life of a person, the internal life of a person. If you don't have enough water, you would be sick. You would have a lot of sickness. Even you can die. The person is supposed to drink more water, like three, like 6 bottles of water, 3 liters, 2 liters, 1 liter. But if you don't drink enough water, you will suffer. So water is very important to the life of a person. That's why we need to deal with water. Water, there is a person, expert person who knows how to go for water. Everything, he was just going to water because he understood that it is only water can help him. So when you get problem, any problem, he runs to water because he understand he has to run to the liver, to the sea, to the ocean to get help. And now, because the water did saved him, so now he said, okay, since the water saved me, I'm going to make this water to my friend. Anything, I know my help will come from the water. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I don't have a lot of internet, so the YouTube is not going to work. I don't know if I lose this video. Anyway, God is good. So, water is very important. Water is very important and very, very, very good to the life. And it is everything. If we don't have water, if we lack water for 3 days, no water, people will be starving, even people will be sick, and it will be a big disaster. So water is very important. Now, when you look at the life of Moses, Moses was saved by the water. When Pharaoh wanted to kill the children of Israel, now the mother of Moses went and hid Moses in the water. Why did he decided to take Moses to the water? What was in the water? The water could swallow that child, but the water did not do anything to the child. So there is something in the water. Because water hears, he does hear. And the water is so powerful. So the mother of Moses, she understood the only salvation, the only way that their son would be saved is to hide him into the water. And that water, there was the children, the daughter of Pharaoh was using that water deliver. Now, when they saw a baby coming within the basket, floating on the water, they went and rescued the child, and adopted that child. They take the child home, and they were happy to have the child. And then her own mother came to nurse him. Now, here is what we know, that water has a meaning, and there's something in the water. So, when you look at the Bible, you see David. When David was being attacked by the water, who delivered God? God delivered David from the water. From the water, when the enemy were using the water to kill David. David has to pray and talk to God until God has to take away the water which was nearly killed David. Let's look in the book of 2 Samuel. 2 Samuel. We can start from 2 Samuel 22, verse 17. And if we could go further, but I know we want to look in verse 17, but you can read the whole chapter if you want. But the Bible says, he sent from on high, that 2 Samuel 22, chapter 22, verse 17. The Bible says, he sent from on high. He took me, he threw me out of many waters. From my enemies. So the enemies of David were nearly killing, but God delivered him. You know that the witchcraft, they use water to take everything from people. Water is a very serious thing. There is a power in the water. There is power in the water. Wicked people, they know how to use the water. And original, it was not so. God created water for his own, for his cleansing. And now when you look at the Bible, there is a lot of scripture talking about water, which means water has some stuff that we need to know. Now, when David was delivered from the height, from many water, David was delivered from the many water, and he was protected from affliction, from the enemy that wanted to kill David. But David was being delivered. In the book of Exodus 32, verse 20, the Bible says, he took the calf which he had made and burned it with fire and ground it to powder, and scattered it over the surface of the water, and made the sons of Israel drink it. You know, this is Moses. Moses understood what is going to happen. Moses, he came with the Ten Commandments, and they found the children of Israel with Aaron worshiping the calf, worshiping the idols, dancing and worshiping. Moses was very angry. He broke the tablet. He beat it down, he threw it and break it to pieces, because he said, why are you worshiping other gods? He was very angry. Now, because the water they are going to drink, what Moses did, he just took that image, that calf, and burned it to ashes. And then, because when you see the ashes also in the Egypt, Moses used the ash to throw on the sky. So Moses, he said that these people, they are the one to use this water. Now I know this water I'm going to destroy, because these people, they are worshiping God, and God is the one who gives them this water to drink. I'm going to put the ashes they've been worshiping and drink on it. So now, if you continue reading that story, you will see what happened. Moses was very angry. Even Aaron begged Moses, please cool you down. Don't kill people. Please let your hunger go down. So, because these people, you know how they are. Yes, but Moses in his heart, he knows, I'm going to destroy the water. This is the power of the water. So if I'm not going to destroy this water, you will continue worshiping these idols. Now, you see, Moses is the one who really, because the water saved him, and he understood how powerful the water is. Now, what happened here in the book of Genesis Genesis, the book of Genesis 24, verse 13 to 19. The Bible says, behold, I'm standing by the spring, and the daughter of men of the city are coming out to draw water. Now, may it be the girl to whom I say, please let down your jug, so that I may drink, and who answer, drink, and I will water your camels. Also, may she be the one whom you have appointed for your servant Isaac, and by this I will. You know, when Isaac was going to get married, the mother of Isaac sent the servant to go and look for a wife. And the only way to get this wife, the servant was going to the water, went to deliver. The servant went to deliver to get water. So, because he said that the only thing that he can help, he can get the answer, or he can get the woman the life, is to go to deliver. That's where the girls are coming. So water connected the servant of Abraham to get the woman. You see? You see the liver. That's why the witches and the wicked people, they know how to manipulate the water and destroy the water, because water has something. Because of the water, that's why Isaac got a wife. Rebecca came from the water. Mm-hmm. You see, Rebecca, although she was wicked, you know, these people from the water spirit, there's something wrong with them. Now, Rebecca, she was found from the water. It is the water which connected Rebecca to marry Isaac. You see now there? So, the servant of Abraham, when he went to the river where the girls were coming, when he saw the girl, he said, thank you. The water connected that girl, and the girl did not say anything. She accepted everything, and the Bible says that she agreed, and she was taken to be a wife of Isaac. Like that, no boyfriend, no. They didn't know each other. He just went and said, okay, I am here to pick you and take you to give your husband. He said, yes. She did not argue. She didn't say, why? Oh, I don't know the person. Let him come to see me. No, they did nothing. The only the parents say bye bye, and there was no wedding. There was no wedding because this man, he was taken like that. I don't see where there was a wedding. There was no wedding. So I'm not saying that so that you can celebrate because you don't want to have a wedding. In the New Testament, that's where we see wedding. But the Old Testament, we only see gifts. But the New Testament is when we see the wedding. Now, the Rebecca was married like that. We thank God for God that connected the Rebecca, and she was married to Isaac. Now, when you look at the book of Exodus, let's look in the book of Exodus. The book of Exodus 2, verse 15. Here is what is about Moses again. As I said that Moses was being rescued, was delivered by the water, when Pharaoh decided to kill the children. Pharaoh said, I don't want to see any male child, so I'm going to kill them, all of them. And now, because he wanted to be killed before they were born, but now they found that the Hebrews women, they give birth without the help of anybody. Now, then Pharaoh decided, okay, even all these children, I'm going to kill them, physical death. So the children were killed. Unfortunately, he didn't kill the one he wanted to kill. The child was being hidden. The mother of Moses hid the child in the water. And Moses was delivered. Then, after being delivered, and then the Bible says, Exodus 2, verse 15 to 22, the Bible says, when Pharaoh heard of this matter, he tried to kill Moses, but Moses flew from the presence of Pharaoh and settled in the land of Midian, and he sat down by a well. Now, the priest of Midian had seven daughters, and he came to throw water and fill troughs of water their father's flock. Now here, you see, you know the story of Moses. Moses ran away from Pharaoh because of what he did. When Moses was growing, he had the Hebrews and Hebrews and the Egyptian fighting. So he went and killed one of them. He killed the Egyptian. Then he didn't know that the Pharaoh would not, nobody knows this. Unfortunately, and then he found the Israel, the beating, is it Israel? They were fighting themselves. Yeah, they were fighting themselves. Now one of them said, "You think you want to kill me like the way you killed the other man?" Then when Moses heard so, Moses said, "Okay, I know these things. It is known. So what will I do? Pharaoh is going to know this and he's going to kill me." Unfortunately, of course, Pharaoh heard so. When Pharaoh heard, according to this scripture, when Pharaoh heard of this murder, he tried to kill Moses. When Pharaoh heard this murder, he tried, so he heard that Moses has killed somebody. So he tried to kill Moses. The Bible says Moses, what Moses did, he went back where he came from. He went to the water. He went to the river. Now, in the river, that's where again he was rescued. That's where he was saved. When he went there, he didn't know what is going to have, what is going to happen. He just went there because he in his life, he understood that the only what can help him is the liver. So he went and stayed there. Then the gas of the priest, it was the gas of the priest, not the gas of the criminal, not the evil gas. The gas of the priest were coming. Then Moses looked at the gas and said, "Okay, I'm going to help you." Moses was a strong man. He started helping the guards. The guards went home very quickly, very very soon. Then the father said, "How is it that you have come so quickly, like soon like that?" Then the guards started explaining to their father. Then the father said, "Where did you leave that man? Bring him home, bring him home." So the water delivered Moses and protected him. Yeah. Yes, you read that scripture, you will see. Because the father-in-law now, the father of the girls, they said, "Bring that man, bring him, he's a good person." The man went to that home and he was given the girl. He married there, Sipora. The girl called Sipora. That's the name of the. So Moses had a recommendation and he was given a woman. He became a child, a child there. You know, Moses, he was lucky. He was adopted everywhere he goes. So, because of water. Moses is from the water, and the water helped him, rescue him, deliver him from his affliction. If Pharaoh could get him, he could have killed him. So he was rescued, and he became a child of that home. You know, first, when he was a baby, he was adopted to the king. Then second, he's now adopted to like a father-in-law, whereby he's being taken care of very well, like a child, because he's married their daughter. Now, water has some connection. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Now, when we see this, you can see, verse 20, the Bible says, the daughters told the father what happened. So the verse 20 says, so he said to his daughter, "And where is he? Why is it that you have left the man? Call him that he may eat bread." Then Moses was content to live with the man, and he gave Sibora, his daughter, to Moses. Yes? Now, that is how Moses was delivered, and Moses was rescued, and Moses, his affliction was destroyed. So, Moses had stayed with the wife he was given, and he gave birth. So we see that through the water, there is blessings in the water, and there is some wicked in the water, because the enemy has taken the water to manipulate and pollute the water. Everything God created perfect good to help us, but the devil Satan, who is our enemy, has polluted the water, has destroyed the water. Yes. Now, let's look on the book of, I think I missed some scripture here. Yes, let us look at the book of Exodus 23, verse 25. The Bible says, "But you shall serve the Lord your God, and he will bless your bread and your water, and I will remove sickness from your midst." Yeah, God is saying that if you serve the Lord with this, with your whole heart, he will bless the bread and bless water, which means water, there's something in the water. Your water must be blessed so that it can take away sickness and diseases, so that it can take the problem. Now, when you see here, God himself says that he will bless, the Bible says, if you shall serve the Lord your God, and he will bless your bread and the water and your water and your water and yes, and your water, and I will remove sickness from your midst. So God will remove the sickness from our midst. He will bless the bread we eat, food we eat, and then he will bless the water. And then he will remove the sickness in the midst, in our midst. We will not have any sickness. Sickness will be destroyed in Jesus' name. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews 10 verse 22, the Bible says, "Let us draw near with a sincere heart in fullness of faith, having our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience, and our body washed with pure water." You know, here is talking really water. Our heart to be washed with pure water. Do you know Jesus, the Son of God, he called his disciples and brought water with their person and started washing them with their feet, because he understand that if these disciples cannot be washed, really water, physical water, they will not make it, because the water, they have to be washed and to be clean. Now here, when we drink the water, the physical water, we pray, we are going to pray for water, and when we drink, our hearts will be healed. Sickness will be destroyed in Jesus' name. Everything, we will take some home and go to split at our homes. I pray that God will deliver you in Jesus' name. There is power in the water. So, yes, now, the Bible says in the book of Ezekiel 36 verse 25, the Bible says, "Then I will split the clean water on you, and you will be cleaned. I will cleanse you from all your filthiness and from all your idols and all your idols." You know, this is physical water. That's why we need to pray for our water to drink and to splint, to splanco. You can take the water, you go and anoint your house, you know, you anoint your home, and then you drink some. You will see what is going to happen. This is the scripture. Yes? There's a time to use the blood of Jesus, there's a time to use water, because water is very, 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 very powerful. Yes. You know, here, that's what God told, that you pray for the water. Even there was a time, people were very sick. Very, very sick, and they didn't know what to do. Then there was a, they said, prepare a pool. Let's make a pool here where people will jump and enter the water and be healed. So some of this water, you can go and bath. You can go and shower in your bathroom. You can go and take shower with this water that we are going to pray. Now, John 5 verse 1 to 5 or to 9, you will see what happened there. It is water, the lily water, the water we have here. It is water that healed sickness, diseases, problem, poverty. When people were chanting, can you get that one? Yes. You can get from, yeah. Or read, Pastor, can you read that, the scripture, please? John 5. John 5 is not there. The Holy Spirit has just reminded me. John 5. The book of John 5. Yes. From verse 1 to 9.
"After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called the Hebrew term Bethesda, having five porches. In this lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool, and troubled the water, and whosoever then thrust after the troubling of the water stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had.
Amen. Amen. This was water. It was not spirit. It was just this water. The bull in the bull. The bull. Now, the Bible says all kinds of sickness and diseases. People were sick. People were having problems. You know, when you have kinds of sickness and there's no doctor. Some sickness like this, they have no doctor. Some sickness like this, doctor cannot help you. It is only you need the water. You need this water to heal you.
Yes.
You need the water to deliver you, to attack your affliction. You only need, that's why sometimes I pray people to water. There was a woman, she was so sick. And then the Holy Spirit did tell me, this woman, she only need water. You don't need, she doesn't need prayers, she doesn't need anything. She only need water. After I prayed for the water, I told her, drink the water. The woman, after they drank the water, the woman, that sickness ceased immediately. She was healed. You know, you see? Yes, you see, the water has power. This water is really power. That's why I've given you so much, a lot of scripture, so that you can go and refer by yourself and see how powerful. The water is the one which connects some people to get married, to get women, without dowry, without anything, without problem. They did not, all this, they didn't know each other. They already been connected. The father gave the Moses a woman. And here, the mother sent the servant to go and look for the wife. The servant got a wife for his master. You see, the wife was being given arrangement, not even arrangement. Water was the one who was connecting everything. Now here we see how water can cleanse, can clean you, can deliver you, and take away all sickness and diseases. And we see the water also protects. You cannot die. The water cannot kill you. Even if you drown, you will be brought up. Because the water can, if the water refuses, it can kill you, yes. But if it refuses you, you cannot. You can. People have been floating in the water and they don't die. So water has power. Water speaks. Water is medication. It heals. And everything we are using is water. I pray that by the power and the blood of Jesus, let this water flow into your heart, into your body, in the mighty name of Jesus. Anyone that is affecting your water, that is a trouble in you from the water of blessings, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Yes, we are want to pray. I'm going to pray. After the prayer, it's when we can pray for the water. The people of Periscope, we will pray that, and then after that, I will come out. I will come off, so you will not see everything. If you need, you have to call me. Yes, thank you. Thank you. If you need me to pray for your water, you will call me. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Thank you, Jesus. My God, we praise your name. We give glory and honor in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank Jesus. We thank Jesus. I'm losing my prayer. Yes. Let's go to the prayer. Let's pray and ask God to forgive us and wash us and clean us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's pray for the water. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. My God, I want to thank you. Let's go to the prayer. Say, Holy Ghost fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
Flush out the poison of the Levantine in my life in the name of Jesus.
Flush out the poison of the rebellion in my life in the name of Jesus.
You know, there's this animals called Levantine. The way you pronounce, I don't know, but it call it Levantine. These animals, it is claiming the water belongs to him. And it trouble the water, it poisoned the water. That's why the water is so polluted. That's why the water is so many sickness coming from the water, because of these animals. has polluted the water, witchcraft has done the water. That's why we need to pray. Anything that this Levantine has done to the water, and you have drink the water, you have to pray that God, let the Holy Ghost flush it out in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. Pray that prayer again.
Holy Ghost fire, flush out the poison of the Leviathan in my life in the name of Jesus.
Holy Ghost fire, burn from the top of my head to the sole of my feet and flush out every marine spirit deposited in my body in the name of Jesus.
Holy Ghost fire, burn from the top of my head to the soles of my feet and flush out every marine spirit deposited in my body in the name of Jesus.
Heaven, great mark of water spirits, be shaken out of my life in the name of Jesus.
Every straight mark of water spirits, be shaken out of my life in the name of Jesus.
Let this water spirit be shaken out of your life. Be shaken in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed and be led and powerless. You water spirit, come out of this person. Come out in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let it be shaken in the name of Jesus. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus. Let water spirit be led and powerless and be shaken in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. Yes, my God. Oh, Lord, bring to my remembrance every spiritual trap and contact in the name of Jesus.
Oh, Lord, bring to my remembrance every spiritual trap and contract in the name of Jesus.
Any contract of spirit with the spirit of water that you have made, you don't know. Let it come to an end. Let's scatter them, render them powerless. Command that contract, cancel that contract in the name of Jesus. Bind them and render them powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, yes, Lord God. My God, let the careful sense of the enemy be dismantled by the, in the name of Jesus. Five. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Let the careful sense of the enemy be dismantled by the blood of Jesus.
Let the careful siege of the enemy be dismantled in the name of Jesus.
The siege of the enemy will be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Will be cut fire and be led and powerless in Jesus' name. Let the siege of the enemy be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Siege of the enemy, you are a liar, we destroy you. We bind you in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Let the blood of Jesus raise every evil record fashioned against me in the name of Jesus.
Let the blood of Jesus erase every evil record fashioned against me in Jesus' name.
I address every evil liver in my place of birth with the blood of Jesus.
I address every evil liver in my place of birth with the blood of Jesus.
Address that liver. Yeah. Satanic liver, witchcraft liver, I address you wherever you are, from my village, from my community, what you are doing there, I address you. I command you to be dried up, to be dried in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. I command you to come to be destroyed in Jesus' name. You will not be functioning in the name of Jesus. You know, the wicked people, they use the river. You think the liver there is a stream of liver, it's passing your village. You go there, you watch, you are happy about it, but you don't know what the wicked have done with that liver. So that's why you address anything programmed there should be destroyed and burned to ashes. Let that liver be dried up and kill every portion and anything that is programmed in the water in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, fire, flush out the portion of the Levantine in my life in the name of Jesus.
Holy Ghost, fire, flush out the poison of the Levantine in my life in the name of Jesus.
We are going to number 10. Every Pharaoh inside the waters, holding my progress and prosperity in the bondage, lose your hold by fire and die in the name of Jesus.
Every Pharaoh inside the waters, holding my progress and prosperity in bondage, lose your hold by fire and die in the name of Jesus.
Do you know that Pharaoh, there was Pharaoh, when Peter was fishing, Peter, he was the expert in fishing. But the Bible tells us that he fished the whole night. He did not get anything. Because of Pharaoh, because of the wicked power, went to catch his prosperity, he hold his business. Now, Peter, they didn't get anything until Jesus came to deliver him. Yes, that's why we pray that there's something in the water. After Jesus speak to the water and told the fish, wherever you are, come. You are there to produce wealth. And Peter became wealthy out of that fish that he catch. He catch a lot of fish that he was breaking the boat, breaking the net. And they were the ones who fishes all. And the person who was telling them, he has no experience of fishing. He was not a fisherman. But because Jesus addressed the lake and told the lake, you produce the fish because you have fish. Peter cannot wasting the whole night without anything. You are a liar. He told all the witches and wizards that stop attacking the lake. There's fish there. And for sure, there was a lot of fish. Yeah? The same spot, and it was daytime. Peter, the fisherman, they fish at night during the dark. But now, when this time, it was daytime, whereby the fish could see the net. But the fish has to obey the word of God, and they started coming to the net. Any power, anywhere, that is all in your prosperity, the water, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. The water that is all in your prosperity, all in your wealth, let it be dried in Jesus' name. You will receive your wealth by fire, by thunder. As you are going to use this water as a point of contact, you will see different. Something is going to happen. You've never seen it. You will drink the water and spring the water in your home. In the mighty name of Jesus. I want to thank God and give God glory. Thank you for those who have come. I will talk to you tomorrow morning. We will be on tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. So God will help you in Jesus' name. I'm going to do the deliverance of the water right now, and God will help you in Jesus' name. If you need me to pray for your water, if you need water, I don't sell water. You get your own water, because the Bible says the word of God, you send the word and the word go through there. So God will touch your water and you will find it, because you need to follow some rules in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. You can view the videos. I've given you the scriptures. It will help you to understand that the water, there's power in the water which can bring prosperity, which can bring you a wife. If you are looking a wife, you are looking for a husband. It will connect you very, very good. We thank God. Amen. We see. That is what we see in the Bible. Yes. So that, and it was easy. No worry. You just get your wife, your husband. That's all. That's all. I thank God. You go. Thank you so much. I love you so much. I love you.